published 1732 Eastern Standard Time, the 21st of February 2018, updated 2016 Eastern Standard Time, the 21st of February 2018, 16 years after Rhona Martin sent down the Stone of Destiny for Winter Olympics curling gold, Eve Muirhead fired the pistol shot that floored a giant and kept Great Britain on course to repeat history. The bare fact is that Muirhead and her team beat Canada 6-5 and are in Friday's semi-finals, where they will face Sweden. Canada had never failed to make the podium in men's, women's and mixed doubles curling in the 20 years since it was added to the games. Eve Muirhead pulled the trigger on her pistol shot to eliminate hot favourites Canada. Team GB's win certainly caused a stir among the sport's followers, and it extended to accusations of betrayal aimed at Britain's coach Glenn Howard, a winner of 4 world championships in Canadian colours. Within 20 minutes of this match finishing, his Wikipedia page was edited, presumably by a Canadian, to brand him a traitor curler, overstating things, perhaps, but it is also a measure of how strongly they feel in Canada about sliding stones down ice. It is an obsession fueled by the sheer dominance of Canadian teams, who had won 6 of the previous 11 Olympic gold medals available. Muirhead played a raised double takeout in the penultimate 10 to swing the match. GB coach and 4-time Canadian world champion Glenn Howard was branded a traitor on social media after eliminating his home nation, all of which makes this win by Muirhead's rink quite exceptional. Canada have been in alarmingly weak form, but as reigning world champions they were seen as the team to beat. The pivotal moment came in the penultimate end, with a score at 4-4 and Muirhead staring at defeat. Canada had 2 stones in the house and 2 more guarding, but the 27-year-old skip pulled off a 4-stone cannon that brilliantly limited the damage to just 1. Usually sir reserve, she leapt across the ice. A 5-4 down, but with the hammer, Britain had their chance in the final end. Muirhead took it with a 2-stone win for 6-5. That game was massive, said Muirhead, who won bronze at Sochi 2014. I kind of knew the outcome, win or lose, and it would have made it hard if we had dropped that game. As a team, we played a fantastic game, very high class, and that was always going to be the case for Great Britain v Canada. LR, Anna Sloan, Muirhead, Vicky Adams and Lauren Gray. After knocking out Canada, former Canada coach Glenn Howard led Team GB to the 6-5 victory on Wednesday and the 9th. That was the big shot and it turned the tables a little bit. As a skip, these are the shots you have to make. Really pleased it came off, and to book ourselves in the semi-final is really special. When I threw it, I was just hoping it was going to come off and the angles were going to work out. Many people have spoken to me about this jump, but I can't actually remember it. I'm just glad that I landed safely on 2 feet. Understandably, Howard, 55, had mixed emotions. It's too bad that it came to us knocking out Canada, he said. I've had the maple leaf on my back and I'm proud to wear that, but I was hired 2 years ago and proud to put GB on my back. I was 110% here for Britain today. It completes an impressive turnaround for Muirhead, whose side drifted into difficulty in the round robin but closed with 3 straight wins to qualify with a 6-3 record. Kyle Smith's men's team faced the Swiss this morning in a playoff to qualify for the semi-finals. It showed we have the determination and patience to see it through, said Muirhead.